or even abolish some of the monuments in western states.
This order is largely in response to a late-hour executive order by President Obama that created the Bears Ears National Monument in Utah, which protected more than 1 million acres of land considered sacred to Native Americans. It's a place where there's been extensive looting and desecration of sacred artifacts. But Trump says that designation was part of a massive federal land grab, and his order would give power back to the states where it belongs. Utah, in particular, has led a far-right movement in western states to transfer federal public land to state hands. Trump's Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke denies this review of the monuments is part of an attempt to transfer that federal land to states that could be privatized. Kirk Ziegler, NPR News.
Stocks are trading higher on Wall Street at this hour. The Dow is up 28 points. The Nasdaq Composite up 2. The S&P 500 up 3 points. This is NPR News in Washington. Of the U.S. are in the path of potentially severe weather today. The National Weather Service has issued warnings for parts of Arkansas and southern Missouri for severe thunderstorms, hail, and possible tornadoes. Parts of Illinois are expected to get severe storms with a chance for flash flooding. Researchers say they found an inexpensive drug that could dramatically reduce maternal mortality around the world. NPR's Michaeline Dublak reports the medicine could save tens of thousands of lives each year.
The major reason women die during childbirth is blood loss. For decades, doctors have known about a drug that could possibly prevent these deaths. It's widely available and easy to use, but no one had thoroughly tested it. So researchers at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine put together a massive study with 20,000 women in 21 countries. Now they report their findings in the journal The Lancet. The drug, called tranexamic acid, reduces the risk of death from bleeding by one-third when given a few hours after childbirth. Researchers say the big challenge now is getting the drug to women who need it the most, those who live in rural, poor areas of the world. Michaeline Dukla, NPR News.
One of America's most influential movie makers has died. Jonathan Demme directed numerous blockbuster hits, including Silence of the Lambs and Philadelphia. He also directed art house films such as Swimming to Cambodia and documentaries about Haiti and Jimmy Carter. And he died of cancer at the age of 73. I'm Winter Johnston, NPR News in Washington.
Support for NPR comes from Bluevine, offering businesses revolving lines of credit to help them grow and expand. Credit lines up to $100,000. Small business credit help is available at Bluevine.com and Americans for the Arts at AmericansForTheArts.org.
On the next Fresh Air, my guest will be Frank Rich, an executive producer of the HBO series Veep that satirizes American politics. Season 6 is underway. Rich is a former New York Times theater critic who also had a Sunday Times column about the intersection of politics and popular culture, a subject he continues to write about in New York Magazine. Hope you'll join us.
Trade disputes all along between the U.S. and Canada. Salmon, oil, dairy products, and forest products, among others. But now, a trade dispute with Canada looks to be the first serious trade crisis of the Trump presidency. The White House announced